everyone. So I hope you're just as excited for Thanksgiving as I am. I finally finalized my Thanksgiving menu. I know I'm late, but it's really hard for me because I have so many ideas and it's hard for me to make a decision. So I finally had to decide on what I'm gonna make, and I did it. My job for Thanksgiving is to make the appetizers, dessert, and side dishes. My dad does the turkey, my mom helps me do the side dishes and the desserts. And my sister's actually gonna join in on the fun this year and help out as well. I'm gonna be making spicy maple rosemary nuts. And my mom's allergic to a lot of nuts, so it's gonna be almonds and peanuts. I'm really excited for it. It's something that I can make ahead and have ready. And yeah, it seems pretty cool. Everybody likes eating some nuts. It's a great appetizer. I'm gonna be making a spanakopita. I found this online, and it's different than the spanakopita I made before. I made spanakopita for, I think I did it for Christmas or Nochebuena. I actually made it for Christmas Eve. And yeah, this recipe is a little different. The structure of it is different. I thought it would be cute. It has greens, so it has a nice color that pops. I like to make appetizers that pop. And this one is very quick and easy. I've seen plenty of spanakopita recipes, and some are harder than others. This one, you know, will give me enough time to do everything else I have to do while still looking and tasting great. So I'm gonna be making my own bruschetta. I'm following a recipe loosely because I have some ideas. I couldn't find one that matches exactly what I want. Most of the bruschetta recipes that I saw that incorporate cranberries do so without using a lot of tomatoes, and they also incorporate cheese. So I don't want that. I just want the bread and my own bruschetta and the balsamic vinegar. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna be using some tomatoes, and I'm gonna incorporate some cranberries, not too much because I don't want it to overpower, but I just want that slight cranberry taste to it. And that, of course, is easy. The hardest part about that is I'm gonna have to get the bread the day of, because nobody wants some hard bread. And I'm also gonna be making the cranberry pecan mini goat cheese balls. And I've made the giant balls, and it's always a hit. I do 3 different cheese balls, and they incorporate different stuff, different nuts, different spices, herbs, cheeses. And this time I'm gonna do it a little different, because this time I wanted to make it very classy. I wanted to do smaller portions, little hors d'oeuvres. So that's what I'm gonna do. It looks really cute. It has a pretzel stick on it, and it has those colors that pop. I'm not gonna use pecans because my mom's allergic. So I'm gonna do something else, maybe almonds, or I don't know, I'll figure it out. I'm great at taking creative liberty. I do follow directions really well, but when the creative juices are flowing, I can't help it. I never make anything the same way unless I've committed it to memory and I just found a way that works. I look at a recipe and I make sure I don't get the scientific parts of it wrong. Like baking, you need to follow it because it could go pretty badly if you don't. But, you know, there are things that you can take creative liberty with if you prefer it to taste a certain way or look a certain way. So that's what I do. Pesto hummus with homemade pita chips. So yeah, I saw that they make the pita chips just from pita, and then they bake it, and that's super easy. I can do that. And I've made hummus before. I've done pumpkin hummus, and this time I'm gonna do pesto hummus. It's gonna bring that green color, and I love pesto. It looked like a really cool recipe and something that's easy and quick that I can do, because I do love my appetizers, but guess what? I love my Thanksgiving meal even more. Shh, don't tell anybody. I make a lot of appetizers to get people full, so then I have a lot of leftovers. I still want people to eat, but I do love my Thanksgiving food the next day. I love making a sandwich with turkey and cranberry and gravy. Ugh, yum. I found this recipe online for egg rolls that are made with leftovers, and that seems so yum. So for drinks, I'm also gonna be making some funky drinks. I'm gonna be having champagne and then pouring in a couple of cranberries in it, frozen cranberries, and yeah, I love that it was a hit the last couple times I've done it. I think it looks really festive and pretty. For the people in my family that don't really drink, they really, really love the champagne with the cranberries because it's super cute. I'm also gonna be making a ginger cranberry cocktail. It seems very refreshing to me. The ginger and the cranberry and the vodka. When we have hard liquor, it's typically vodka, so I know it'll be a hit. I have a really cute picture that I want to use that'll go really, really well with our theme. So yeah, I'm excited. So for the main meal, I don't do the turkey, my dad does, but I do help with the side dishes. We make the mashed potatoes and the yams. Cranberry sauce. I make the cranberry sauce. I don't want to toot my own horn, but I'm pretty good at it. I like it to be a little spicy, but also sweet. I like it to be the perfect amount. And yeah, the key to that is just trying as you go and just doing what you feel. I have good instinct for it. My grandma makes the cornbread and she makes the gravy. Oh, we also do the stuffing, of course. My mom's gonna do a new stuffing this year, so we're gonna be working on that. And I'm sure it's gonna turn out great. Her stuffing is always a hit. Everybody always says she makes the best stuffing. We're gonna do things a little different this year. So super excited. Dessert. Okay, so we got these pumpkins at a pumpkin patch, and apparently there's like these really weird pumpkins. Nothing I've ever seen down here. And one of them is this green pumpkin that's apparently supposed to be very sweet and great for pumpkin pie. So that's what we're gonna use. We're gonna make it from scratch. I know I did a video on easy pumpkin pie and I told you guys that's great for a quick pumpkin pie for a party that you're going to or Friendsgiving. And it's true, it is. But this one, you know, we're going all out. We're gonna make the pie shells from scratch. We got these cookie cutters to cut the pastry in these nice little fall shapes, pumpkins, leaves, all that. I'm also gonna be making pecan pie for the first time. Never made it before. I love pecan pie. I usually stray from making anything that my mom's allergic to, but yeah, she's not big on eating dessert these days and everybody loves pecan pie, so that's what we're gonna do. So yeah, that's what's on the menu this year. Yeah, things may change. I may make more things because I'm crazy, but yeah, I only have 13 people coming and I don't know, I love going full out and I always make more than enough food, but hey, that's me. We only got a little bit of groceries. Yeah, I even have stuff on my hand too. Just got home and unpacked the groceries and I'm so beat. It was a lot. I don't remember the last time we got so many groceries, but we got mostly everything. As we get closer, I need to get the baguette and I need to get the pita bread. We actually got the turkey last time we went to Publix last week and we got a 28-pound turkey. It's perfect, huge. I'm gonna have plenty of leftovers and that's my favorite, so we're all set. Yeah, it was a little bit stressful. There was a lot of stuff to get, but we did it. So, yay! I love Thanksgiving, I'm super excited. Don't forget to subscribe, more videos to come. Don't forget to like, comment, what are you doing for Thanksgiving? What are you making? What are you excited for? Yeah, and a happy holiday season. I hope you guys have a great Thanksgiving. Yeah, thank you guys.